Thank you for being here. Hope you're doing well. In today's video, I want to show you my process when I do a Facebook plant purge. I thought that this would be a perfect time to show you as I'm getting ready to get rid of a few plants because I'm downsizing my collection. I am officially back at work in the office and I have a little bit less time for my entire collection. I want to make sure that every plant that I have in my collection is something that I love, something that I enjoy taking care of, and that's currently not where I'm at. So I want to give those plants a second life and a second home. And that's what the plant purge today is about. Now, also a big factor in getting rid of a few plants. As a beginner, I felt like I needed every plant and I would see all of these Instagram accounts with jungles basically in their homes. And I like the look in pictures and I like the look in other homes if, you know, they're decorated correctly. I don't feel like I have that space. And so also when I'm going plant shopping, for example, whether online or at a big box store, I'm a lot more specific and particular about the plants that I want to bring into my collection. So the first step in this plant purge process, and it does take a few steps, mostly because there's sort of like this standard for plant purges. The plant pages that I prefer to purge on are just local plant pages. I'm not currently looking to ship any plants. Step one in a plant purge, I go around my collection and I basically go through and decide, do I like this plant? Is this plant something that's giving me a headache? Does this plant require more work than I'm willing to put in?
All right, you can stay. You can stay this time. Snake plant. Classic. You seem to be pretty happy in my care, so I think I will keep you. Now you. You are a different story. I might have to put you on the chopping block. Sorry.
I highly recommend this next part in preparation for the plant purge, simply because it will make your life a lot easier and it lets them know that you're prepared and that you have plants lined up one after the other and they're not having to wait. That's a part of being prepared. So step number two is to gather your plants and take pictures. It gives the buyer the opportunity to fully look at the plant. When taking pictures of the plant, you also want to get from the top, you want to get from the side. If there's any sort of damage on the leaf, you want to make sure you get that damage so that the buyer knows exactly what they're getting. Details and different angles and all of that stuff, that will make the buyer feel more comfortable commenting sold. If the plant has various angles, make sure that the pictures are well lit and that you can see exactly what the plant is. Okay, so the third step is to gauge interest. Now you can do that in a few different ways. My best recommendation is just to post. I typically like to ask when people are most likely to hop onto a purge, if there is any interest for the plants that I have listed, and then the date that you are thinking of doing the plant purge as well. And in that post, you will be able to gauge the best time. If you have a date, the best time for that date, that would be really helpful. And that made my first plant purge actually very successful because accommodate it, of course, if you can, accommodate to the times that you're seeing more popular. That way that you get the most traffic when you are beginning your plant purge. All right, so that concludes part one of our two-part plant purge series. I'm really excited to film that part for you. Stay tuned for that next Wednesday at 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. If you did like this video and found it helpful, please give me a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed already, make sure you do so. I really appreciate you staying with me until the end, and I really hope to see you here next week. Bye.